Did you date anyone before Shams? These pants are so comfortable. I got them from Michael Kors. They're actually my mom's.
Hi.
What is up, everyone? I have not made a YouTube video where I've just like sat and talked to a camera in forever. I also realized I have had this YouTube channel for 2 years now and I have yet to make an intro video. You guys have sent a bunch of questions in asking about myself, so hopefully you'll be able to get to know me a little better. Also, why do I sound out of breath for like 2 seconds of me prancing around? Okay, so I have the questions on my phone. Number one is, how old are you? I am 24 years old. My birthday was January 5th, 1996. January 5th is also the Big Up Adugun's birthday, so I consider myself very lucky that we share a birthday. I am a Capricorn and very much like a typical Capricorn, I think so. Number two, where were you born? I was born in Houston, Texas, but only lived there for like 6 months. My dad was doing his residency at Baylor. I lived in West Lafayette, Indiana for 10 years, Solon, Ohio for the next 10 years, and then went to University of Michigan for 4. So through and through, I am a Midwestern baby. I definitely have like that Midwest homie kind of vibe. What did you want to be when you were a child? Honestly, I think as a child, I might have fantasized like being a Bollywood actress, but for the most part of my childhood, I think I wanted to be a doctor or a consultant. Like, I genuinely was passionate about the sciences. I thought I wanted to become a doctor. Either it's doctor or it's like business. So I thought I wanted to do one or the other. And clearly, I'm not a doctor. Also, I feel like till date, I still throw out 5 or 6 professions. Oh, I wanna like start a shoe line, or oh, I wanna, you know, act in this, or oh, I wanna like start this $1 million business. I think I have a lot of ideas and plans. So let's see what the future unfolds. I think it'll be interesting to watch this video 20 years from now and be like, what did Shivani think she was gonna be when she was 24? Am I in focus? I feel like that's such a like YouTuber thing to say, you know, when people are like, am I in focus or not? Number two was, or number, what are we? I can't count. 1, 2, 3, 4. How was your college experience? I think I had the best college experience possible. I have thoughts whether the degree and coursework were actually valuable, because in reality, I don't think that they were. But I learned so much through the internships I did throughout college, co-ops I did. Overall, I made these lifetime value friendships. I also met Sham, so that was good. I think a lot of people say that college is the best 4 years of your life, and 100% I had an amazing college experience, but I'm definitely of the belief that I've had amazing years outside of college as well, and I know that there's so much more excitement to come. So anyone who's going into college, know that even if you're not having the best time, like, you're gonna experience amazingness in a different phase of your life. What was your first job? I think my first job where I actually got paid was, I was a dance teacher like when I was 14 or 15 years old. That's when I started. I used to teach younger kids dances for the Valley programs, Holi programs. I once taught a bride like how to just dance at her reception. She was just like, Shivani, when the music turns on and DJ is gonna play, how should I just like dance? So it was literally like, this is how you dance, like do moves like this. Like, it was so dorky, but I think she paid me like $40 an hour. I'm not even joking. What religion do you follow? My family is Sanak Basi Jain, and I grew up learning about Jainism. I think my parents did a great job of presenting religion in a way that it didn't seem too forced. My dad is agnostic. As much as he believes in the tenets of Jainism, his core philosophy was always be a good human being every single day. So that value set that I think Jainism provides was definitely set at a foundational level. We used to go to Pachala growing up, like Sunday school, which we gave our mom a really hard time for, but it's okay. In sixth grade, I went to Mumbai alone. I spent a summer living with my Masi and my Nani. And my Masi's mother-in-law knows so much about Jainism. She's taught me everything that I know, or mostly everything that I know, from Samayik to Logas to Ichhakarenam to all, I mean, I would recite for you, but this is not the time or place. Maybe during Pajushan, I will make a vlog about Jainism properly. What's your favorite city? So short answer, I think Mumbai or New York, just simply for the work experiences that they've given me. The hustle and energy of both of those cities is just incredible. I thrive off of that. But I've also realized I'm the kind of person that I am truly happy in any city I live in, as long as I have my people around me or I'm just busy in work. Every single city has its pros and cons. There's no perfect city. If you're in Cleveland, then you're dying in the cold. And if you're in Mumbai, then you're in monsoons. So like, oh God, what does that scream? Right now I'm living at home with my parents in Cleveland, Ohio, and I am as happy as can be. So I think a lot of people like glamorize the big city, but there is definitely charm in the Midwest and having space and being in nature. So, you know, I think the grass is always greener on the other city. Did you date anyone before Shams? Short answer is no. He is the only person I have been with, I've liked, I've dated. I have no crazy high school or college fling story. Like, it sounds kind of boring, but I guess it worked out. Next question is, do you want to be a Bollywood actress? This is actually a huge misconception. I have definitely dabbled in acting auditions, but my goal was never to be a Bollywood actress for three reasons. One, I can't act to save my life. I learned that while living in Mumbai. Two, I personally don't feel comfortable doing kissing scenes, and if I want to do something, I want to do it at the biggest scale. And the reality is, all Bollywood films, all big TV shows, everything these days kind of has kissing scenes, and it just wasn't something I was willing to negotiate on. Number three, after interning in Mumbai, I saw up close and personal that it's not as glamorous as it seems. There's a lot of murkiness, a lot of shit that I didn't want to deal with. I'm a very straightforward and simple girl, and I just don't think being fully immersed in that industry is like what I would want. I really enjoy being more on the peripheral, the TV show hosting, interacting with celebrities, kind of building that network. Okay, that was a lot. What was the hardest part of living in Mumbai? Growing up, I would go to India once a year, visit for a few days, attend the wedding, you're getting pampered, you're eating great food. But the moment you start living in Mumbai, it's a brand new roller coaster, right? No one can prepare you for what it takes to live in a completely different culture in a very different city. The hardest part about living for me would probably have to be accepting the fact that many things about Mumbai are not gonna change, right? And are not gonna change overnight. There's traffic, there's pollution, there's a lot of chaos. As someone that's like, no, like, I'm gonna fix this, and ye theek ho sakta hai, aur ye aise chal jayega, and like, you kind of have to come to terms with the fact that not everything is in your control in the city, and even if you think things should operate in a certain way, it's not gonna happen. So I think that acceptance was probably the hardest thing to develop. Your hardest part about working in Mumbai. Overall, I think there's a lack of professionalism and no one values your time. So to get your shit done, you kind of have to start playing this game. You have to raise your voice, kind of get on top of people, baby people, and Dalisa! It's gonna take me 15 minutes. I need to get going. That was probably the hardest part, is like learning that even if you wanna be super kind and friendly all the time, to get your work done or to get that result, you might have to like be a different way for those like 10, 15 minutes. Your favorite part about living in Mumbai? Okay, so many things. I am someone, I get very defensive about Mumbai. I will like stand by that city through thick and thin. I would say access to amazing food, eating roadside safe puri twice a week, the overall just energy, the work opportunities I got in Mumbai. Everyone from your auto wala to your sabzi wala to people working corporate, like everyone in that city is on a mission. I also really enjoy spending time with my masis, with my chachi, chacha, with my cousins. So much family that I think I wouldn't have built that close a relationship with if I wasn't living in Mumbai. Okay, this one's funny. Why does your accent change? I'm a second or third generation Indian American, however you see it. And both my mom and dad were born and raised in the US. They have never lived in Mumbai, or they've never lived in India, sorry. I was also born and raised in the US, and I've only lived in India for the 1.5 years I was in Mumbai. Growing up, right, we used to visit India once a year. Mehndi bol sakti hu. So I think I was built with this ability to code switch. So depending on who I'm speaking to make sure I kind of fit in and the other person feels comfortable, my accent does change. So if I'm talking to my friends, I'm gonna speak English the way I've always spoken it at school. If I'm doing an interview, let's say, with like a Nawazuddin Siddiqui sir, right, who isn't as comfortable in English, if I spoke to him like this, he would look at me and be like, what is this girl saying? You know, like, ekdam se, like, he would feel more conscious of the words that he's using rather than feeling like it's a comfortable conversation. So naturally, my accent will switch a little and I'll talk a little bit like this. And does it make sense what I'm saying? Only, you know, like, my English just changes. Not that I am having an identity crisis or anything. It's just depending on if I'm speaking to my nanny, it's gonna sound different than if I'm speaking to my non-desi friend from high school. And then if I'm speaking to like an auto wala, like the whole, or like my crew in Mumbai, it's gonna be like, kya chal raha hai, banta log, like, you know, like that kind of slang. So I don't know, I think it's important to be able to be adaptable. A funny story is, I had done a video with Nick, BU Nick. The first video we did, I spoke fully in Hindi. But ending credits mein, I said, you know, if you like this video, like, comment, subscribe. And that was in my normal American accent. And all of the comments on that video were like, oh my god, this girl is so fake, like, ye kya firang banna chahti hai? And I'm like, that is genuinely how I speak. But I loved that people bought the fact that I sound like I was, you know, fully fluent in Hindi and was from India. Were you always obsessed with Bollywood? I grew up obsessed with Bollywood, and not just like your stereotypical, I love Kuch Kuch Hota Hai in K3G, like, wala obsessed. I mean, I know each and every Bollywood movie, the gossip, the songs. Like, I will challenge any of you to my knowledge of Bollywood, even though I know, like, my friends are gonna come and be like, well, J-Raj beat you. I have done the craziest things to just get a glimpse at Bollywood actors. I once found out that Shamita Shetty was staying at the same hotel as a wedding that we were attending in Goa. Somehow faked my way to, like, the hotel staff to figure out her hotel room number. Literally just, like, rang her doorbell of her room just to get an autograph of her. I've stood outside of Jalsa for like 30 minutes in that, like, massive crowd hoping to get a glimpse of Amitabh Bachchan sir. I once saw Suhana Khan at a Candies, I think, in Bandra, and we were eating dessert and I was like, oh my god, it's Suhana Khan. And I started freaking out. Then the moment she left, I, like, went and sat in that chair. Okay, like, Suhana Khan is kursi mein baithi thi. It's definitely inbuilt, and I don't think I've ever shied away from expressing my love for Bollywood. What are your favorite foods? Oh, so many. I love all khana with garlic and onion and basil, just like strong flavors. I douse sriracha and everything. Mujhe achar ka bahut shauk hai. I really like tikka food. Some favorite foods would be Thai food, my family's Mexican recipes, falafel, pizza. My mouth is really just thinking about this. Are you competitive? I am very, very competitive. I don't think I've ever played a game to just have fun. I'm gonna admit, like, I have cheated here and there. I don't think I'm a serial cheater, but like, agar tum patti dikhaoge to, like, I'm gonna see it, you know? I mean, that's on you, right? Like, you should hide your cards. I love code names, taboo, desi shot, which is like the Indian version of taboo. I've shared that on my stories a few times. We play a lot of Indian card games. We play Kanasta, Kali Begum, Judgment, Hearts. One more. What's one thing no one knows about you? I think people do know this if you follow me on Instagram, which you totally should follow me on Instagram. But at heart, I am a major bum and, like, weirdo. I feel like it sometimes doesn't come across enough on content, and people, like, view me as like a, oh my god, she's so proper. I love sleeping. I love living in pajamas. I can sleep anywhere and everywhere for like 14, 15 hours. Late baby, mujhe bas ek rajai de do, and like, I'm knocked out. It's my passion. I feel like I do really weird things. Like, I speak in really weird voices, which my friends and parents know. I'm a prankster. I love, like, making people around me laugh and, like, just doing dumb things just to, like, get that laugh. Coming from, I think, a pretty extended family-wise, probably a more traditional Marwari Gen family, there has been like this notion, you know, you have to be in a certain way, and like, I can be that girl. But I think my parents, Sean, my friends, have never made me feel like, oh, I have to be more normal. I don't know if I'm describing it properly, right? But I think I'm very free and I feel very comfortable in my own skin, and that's a blessing. That is such a privilege to be able to say that. Wow, I'm sounding so senti. But I think, like, from a very young age, I've been encouraged to, like, do a lot of things, which has really helped me in my self-confidence. Wow, where did this, like, kaha se kaha ye conversation ho gaya? Okay, but thank you guys so much for watching. I don't know how many questions I answered. Clearly, I have a lot more. I love you all.